Namaste, dear students. As usual, first of all, I want to welcome you to our English class of grade 9. I hope you might have been ready with your necessary materials. And your necessary materials are your English textbook, exercise book, and pen or pencil. Are you ready with them? Good. Now, we are going to start our new unit. And can you tell me? Which unit is this? All right, we are going to start unit 11. So all of you turn to page correctly, okay? Are you ready? Good. Now, what do you see there in unit 11? Can you tell me? All of you tell me the title of the unit. What is it? Good, it is. So I just want to show you the pictures first. And you have to tell me, okay? So, what are these things in the pictures, you know? So, you can see mobile, camera, you know, laptop, and many more you can see here. So, what are these things called? Can you tell me? All right, they are gadgets. And similarly, I want to show you some other pictures. You can see these are the example of instruments, okay? Instruments. So here you can see weather instruments. These instruments are used to measure weather. For example, you can say thermometer, anemometer, okay, hygrometer, like this you can find. So what difference do you find? Look at these are the gadgets and these are the instruments. And our theme, as you have already said, gadgets and instruments. We are going to learn a new lesson. So are you ready for it? Good. Now you can see here getting started. Okay, so here is an instruction. Now let me read this instruction. You also read with me and we have to do a short task. Okay, and the instruction is the following pictures show the process of making black tea. Describe the step each picture shows. Dear students, at your home also, in the kitchen, have you ever made a cup of tea? Many times. Good. So can you tell me, what are the steps of making black tea? Now for this one, you have to look at these pictures. Now the first picture. So what do we need to do? All right, first of all, we have to pour water in the kettle. Then what do we need to do? Good job. We have to keep the kettle on the stove, gas stove, okay? Then what do we need to do? Yes, we have to let it boil. See, you can see. And in the fourth picture, what do we need to do again? Wow, you are so smart. We have to let it boil for 3, 4, or 4, 5 minutes, okay? And then finally, what do you do after making this tea? Well done. Then it is ready for serving. Then we pour it in a cup and then we serve it to our guests, our family members, our friends. So good job. Dear students, now from this activity, I hope you might have guessed what we are going to learn today. Is it making a cup of tea? No. So for this one, you have to look at this picture once again and you will make a good guess. Okay. So the instruction says, look at the picture and answer the questions. See, we are going to learn a new text under reading 1. So have you seen it? Good job. Now, the first question for you. You can see this picture. What do you think the girl is doing here? So can you tell me? The girl is sitting. She has something in her hand. And you can see here plug also. So what is she doing? Yes, the girl is using her mobile phone. Okay. So have you seen it? Good job. Then next question. What is the risk of using a phone this way? Do you also use your phone in this way? So what is wrong there? All right. See, she is using her mobile phone charging on the plug, you know. Is it a good idea? No. See, if we use our mobile phone like this, then what may happen? So another question for you. Okay. The question is, what precautions should you take while using a phone? So what things you have to be very careful while using our mobile phone. See, we should not charge our mobile phone and use together. It is dangerous. We may get an electric shock, you know. So the girl is doing this thing, which is very wrong. Okay? So now, after this discussion of the questions, now can you tell me what are we going to learn in our today's class? What is it? Okay, let me show you. Now, save your smartphone, mobile phone, okay? So we are going to begin the first paragraph. I want to show you a model reading, and you have to also read with me after I read. Okay, so all of you listen to me first. Save your smartphone. Our title is Save Your Smartphone. Okay, mobile phone. I think these days you are very used to using this mobile phone. So is it good to use very much mobile phone? No, we have to use it pretty properly. Now, what things are given in our text? Let's start. You can see the pictures. Okay, so let me read first. Smartphones have become an important aspect of everyday life, not only in terms of staying connected with family and friends, but also in getting work done, staying up to date with important schedules, and even buying groceries or clothes online. It's become almost impossible to do anything without one in today's tech-driven world. So much so that many of us have a phone in our hands for the most part of the day. Your phone therefore needs proper care to prolong its lifespan and also to safeguard important information that's stored there. Since smartphones are so essential and central to our life, it's time for us to get smart in carrying them. Dear students, now it's your time to read this paragraph as I have read for you. Now all of you start reading it. Are you reading? Good. I hope you might have finished reading. Now, I want to ask you a few questions based on this paragraph, and you have to tell me the answers, okay? So, can you tell me why do we use mobile phone? Good job. See, you can find this answer here. Staying connected with family and friends, okay? And then you can find buying groceries or clothes online. Another you can find staying up to date with important schedules, you know. So very interesting, you know. We don't use mobile phone just for contacting our persons. Even we use a mobile phone for online shopping, for keeping ourselves updated with the current affairs, you know. So it's very important these days. And you can find majority of the people are using smartphones a lot, okay? And you should not forget that this is tech-driven world. So what do you mean by tech here? So it is technology, okay? So if we don't know anything about technology, then we remain backward. That's why this is the age of science and technology, and we have to be also friendly with these gadgets, okay? Dear students, and at the same time, if you are using your mobile phone, smartphone, you know, at that time, you should be able to care your smartphone, mobile phone. For example, there are some tips for you. Why do we need to save? Otherwise, we cannot use our mobile phone for a long time. So, is the idea clear given in this first paragraph? Have you understood it? Good job. So, looking at the pictures also, you can see the functions of a smartphone. See, they are talking. They are at the difference and they are talking using their smartphones. And here you can see, we can just order staying at our home and then we can get the things at our gate, you know. So, online shopping. Very interesting, you know. And it was very much useful during lockdown in our country. Dear students, I hope you might have understood this paragraph. Now, I want to take you to another paragraph. Before that one, you should know the meanings of some unfamiliar words. Here you can see prolong. So you have to also pronounce with me, okay? P-R-O-L-O-N-G, prolong. All of you, please pronounce it. Prolong. Good. Once again, P-R-O-L-O-N-G, prolong. All of you pronounce once again. Good. And the meaning of prolong is extend the duration of. It means that if you don't care your smartphone, then you cannot use for a long time. It does not work any longer. Okay? So if you want to extend the lifespan, if you want to prolong the lifespan of your mobile phone, or it means if you want to use for a long time, then you have to take care of it. Is it clear? Good job. Then next word we have essential. All of you pronounce it once again. E-S-S-E-N-T-I-A-L. Essential. So what is it? Yes, essential. So what does essential mean? Can you make a guess in this context? What does it mean? Okay, don't worry. Essential means absolutely necessary, extremely important. Okay, that is very, very much important for us. Dear students, I suggest you to write down these words' meanings in your notebook. Have you written them down? Good. Now, we have some tips. Here are some tips which you can follow to keep your phones safe. Now, the first tip we are going to learn. A closer look at your charging habits. Now, what is your charging habit? How much do you charge your smartphone? You know, these things you can find. And look at the picture. Here is 40% and there is a tick mark, okay? And here is 100% and here is a cross mark. So what does it mean? Now you have to understand this in this paragraph. So I want to read it and you have to also read with me. Let's start. A closer look at your charging habits. Most of us live in fear of a fading phone battery when we are out and about. We don't worry too much about that battery's eventual lifespan. Do you know that you should not charge your battery to 100%? You should not let it get down to minimum charge or 0% either. That can cause internal damage to your phone. The rule with some batteries is to keep them 50% or more most of the time. When it drops below 50%, top it up a little if you can. You can charge your phone this way a few times in a day. You should also make it a point to use the charger that came with your phone. There have been incidents of cheap chargers actually catching fire. So, dear students, now what is the percentage of the battery that you need to charge? Can you tell me? Okay, see? 100% also, sometimes that may not prolong the lifespan of the battery. And what about below 40% charge? That is also not good, you know. So whenever you are, when you find that your battery is low, you know, at that time you have to charge. And you are suggested to charge your battery at least 40%, okay? And if you get it down, let's say less than 40%, then you have to immediately charge it. And there is the rule of charging at least 50% for some batteries also. So it means that if we want to prolong the battery, then we have to charge it very properly. So is the idea clear to you from this paragraph? Good. Again, you can see some unfamiliar words here, highlighting words. For example, fading. So what does fading mean in this context? See, most of us live in fear of a fading phone battery. So what does it mean? Now, before knowing the meaning, you need to pronounce it. Fading. All of you pronounce it. Fading. F-A-D-I-N-G. Fading. So what does it mean? Let me show you. Fading means gradually growing faint and disappear. So if the brightness is going down and down, you know, that is what we call fading, okay, less bright. And another word we have is lifespan, L-I-F-E-S-P-A-N, lifespan. All of you pronounce it, lifespan. What is it? Good, lifespan. And what's the meaning of lifespan? Can you tell me? Don't worry, I am here to help you. So lifespan means the length of time for which a person or animal lives or a thing functions. Okay, so if you want to make your mobile lifespan longer, then you have to take care very properly. Okay, dear students, again write down these words and meanings in your notebook. Have you written down? Good. Now, after this, again, I want to take you to another tip, that is maintain a cool temperature. You can see here to show the temperature, okay, and it is very interesting. We don't care our gadgets very properly, okay, wherever we like to keep, we keep there, you know, so you have to be very careful. Maintain a cool temperature. First of all of you, read with me. It is harmful to phone batteries. Your phone is safest at room temperature. Avoid placing it next to other devices such as laptops as they generate heat. If you are keeping all your gadgets right next to one another, try to separate them. So is it interesting? You can see some of the people, you know, keep their mobile phones, smartphones on the laptop also. They keep their laptop and desktop together, mobile phones, everything, you know. So is it good? No. So what do we need to do? How do you keep your mobile's battery safe? Yes, we have to maintain cool temperature. It means that there should not be more temperature, and our room temperature is okay. That is fine, okay? And dear students, you have to be very careful that if you keep your smartphone with the laptop or desktop, that is not good. Can you tell me the reason why it is not good to keep with the laptops or desktops? Yes, perfect answer. Because laptops, desktops, you know, they generate, they produce heat, and that may cause damage in our battery. Is it clear, all of you? Good. If so, now you can see again highlighted word here, and that may be an unfamiliar word for you. Okay, so what does it mean? You can read this line once again and try to guess the meaning of this word. Avoid placing it next to other devices such as laptops as they generate heat. So what does it mean? All of you tell me loudly. Okay, let me check whether you are right or wrong. See, generate means produce or create. So write it down in your notebook. Generate means produce or create. Dear students, let's practice pronouncing this word. G-E-N-E-R-A-T-E, generate. All of you. G-E-N-E-R-A-T-E, generate. All of you pronounce it. G-E-N-E-R-A-T-E, good. Generate. Okay? Generate. Dear students, there can be other unfamiliar words in the text. So for it, you have to consult your Hard Dictionary or e-dictionary, okay? You should learn to use the dictionaries also. Now, I want to give you another tip again. So what is the tip? See, invest in phone wipes or cleaning solution. How often do you clean your mobile phones? What do you do? Do you use water and soap to clean your mobile phone? Oh, that's a foolish idea, you know. So what do you do instead? Yes, you have to take a piece of soft cloth and then you have to wipe. Or you may get some other chemicals in the market, okay? So this is what. Now, all of you read with me together, and I want to ask you some questions after our reading. So are you ready for it? Good. So let's start then. Invest in phone wipes or cleaning solution. Your phone is a breeding ground for germs and bacteria. Think of all the things you touch before touching your phone. Go to the restroom, hold money, eat, and other activities that lead you to gunk up your device. Studies have actually found that your phone screen houses more bacteria than a toilet seat. This is why you should clean your phone regularly. All you have to do is simply disinfect your phone with an antimicrobial spray and wipe it with a soft cloth. So it's very interesting. So what is dirtier, you know? Is it toilet or our mobile phone? What do you find in the paragraph? Is toilet dirtier than mobile phone? Oh, when we think, you know, toilet is a dirtier place, okay? But if you read this paragraph, and some of the researches have said also that our mobile phone is dirtier. Do you know why? Because every time we use our hand and we hold our mobile, we catch the mobile with our hand, and the bacteria from our hand easily can go to our mobile phone. That's why frequently we have to clean our mobile phone. If we don't clean, then we may suffer from germs, bacteria, you know. So it is very interesting. And do you know, there is gunk, so a kind of sticky type of thing, you know. So you can find chap chap, you know, in your mobile phone because of dot. Phoharle garda chap chap huncha mobile phone haru. So we have to be very careful. So we can find bacteria, germs stay there. So it is very dangerous. That's why you have to regularly clean your mobile phone. Dear students, what do you use to clean your mobile phone based on this paragraph? Please tell me. Okay, very good answer. See, you can clean your mobile phone with antimicrobial spray. You can find it, you can buy it in the market, okay? And then you have to wipe it with a soft cloth, okay? You have to use very soft cloth. Otherwise, your mobile phone may be scratched, you know. So you have to be very careful. And it is better to wash our hands before using the mobile phone. Is it clear to you? Now, can you tell me which are the unfamiliar words in this paragraph? Okay, let's talk about this word, G-U-N-K. How do you pronounce it? G-U-N-K, gunk. All of you pronounce, please. G-U-N-K, gunk. Once again, G-U-N-K, gunk. Good. Now, what does it mean? Now, read this line once again. Think of all the things you touch before touching your phone. Go to the restroom, toilets, okay? Hold money, eat, and other activities that lead you to gunk up your device. So, we can find dot in our mobile. And when that becomes more, then we can find, you know, a kind of sticky type of thing. Chap chap lagne, you know. So, this is what. So, from this, I hope you might have got the meaning of this word. So, have you written it down in your notebook? So, what did you write there? All of you tell me, please. I want to hear loudly. Okay, your meaning is an unpleasantly sticky or messy substance. Or you can write down, it is sticky dot. Okay, so you are right. So, is the idea given in this paragraph clear to you? Good. After this, again, we have another tip, and that is, you can see this is your smartphone and it is locked. So these days you people use pattern, numbering, you know, sensor, maybe fingertips, you know. So using these all things, we lock up our mobile phone. Now all of you read it, and I want to ask you the questions, and you have to tell me the answers based on this paragraph, based on this tip. And the tip is, protect your phone and data. Now, all of you read with me. Set a screen lock on to keep your information safe and render the phone useless in the event it gets lost or stolen. Not using a lock screen is the Android equivalent of going out and leaving your front door open for burglars. See, it is. Suppose if you don't lock up your door of your house, what would happen? Of course, burglars, you know, may enter your house and take all the valuable things. And like this, if we don't lock up our phone, what would happen? See, if you want to keep your mobile phone information safe, you have to lock it up, okay? And another important thing is that you might have stored their photographs, videos, information, messages, you know, and if you want to save them also, you have to lock your mobile phone. If you don't lock, what will happen? Yes, your information may be stolen. Okay, so people can use and they can easily take out the information from your smartphone. That's why you can find numbering lock, pattern lock, let's say body part censorship lock, you know, you can find. Even sound can lock also. These days you can find varieties of locking system in our mobile phone. Okay, so is the idea clear? Good. Now again, so here is one highlighted word, and that is render. All of you read the spellings and then pronounce with me. R-E-N-D-E-R, render. R-E-N-D-E-R, render. All of you pronounce it once again. R-E-N-D-E-R, render. And what does it mean? Have you written down its meaning in your notebook? I hope you have already done. So what is it? Okay, let me check whether you are right or wrong. See, render means to cause something to be in a particular condition. See, to cause something. Okay, you have to understand in such a way. Dear students, after this again, we have another tip for you. That is control app permissions and notifications. So you can see these are the examples of apps. Apps means applications in our mobile phone. For example, if you want, I think you are familiar with Facebook. Do you have your Facebook account? See, do you have, let's say, interesting TikTok? Do you have Twitter? You know, see, YouTube. Okay, so these all are applications, apps. And if we download them and if we install in our mobile phone, then only we can use. Okay, so now all of you read with me. Your smartphone would not be all that useful without all the apps you have downloaded. The more apps you download, the more notifications you will receive. But you can have more control over which apps and events can send you prompts and how these messages appear on the home or lock screen of your phone. Simply go to your phone settings and set the notifications accordingly. Dear students, I believe that almost all of you are using mobile phones and you know how to download applications, for what purpose we have to use different applications, you know. So you can find these are some examples. Okay, do you have your TikTok ID? Oh, maybe. And what do you do there? Maybe you sing and dance, you know, for short video purpose. Maybe you are connected through your Facebook with many persons, you know. So these things are. And if you want to watch video, you know, you can download YouTube. If you want to write down, let's say, email, you know, you can download their Gmail. Many more you can find. Okay, so here, and if you have these applications on your mobile phone, what do you get? You will get notifications. Okay, and using those applications, then you can share your ideas, you can exchange your views, opinions, you can receive such informations from the senders, you know. This is what we do. Okay, now here we have, I think that you don't know the meaning of these words. Okay, so I want to read out the spellings. You also read with me and try to practice pronouncing these words first. Let's start. N-O-T-I-F-I-C-A-T-I-O-N-S, notifications. How do you pronounce it? Notifications. Once again, notifications. Good job. Next word we have P-R-O-M-P-T-S, prompts. See, this P is silent. If you pronounce, no problem, or you can keep this P silent. Okay, you can pronounce P-R-O-M-P-T-S, prompts. P-R-O-M-P-T-S, all of you tell me, prompts. You are right. Now, do you know the meaning of the word notifications? What does it mean? See, it's very simple. You will get bell ring type of sound, you know, in your mobile phone when you get new notification. So what does it mean? So that means information, or you can say notices. Okay, so another word we have is prompts. So what does it mean? Okay, let me show you. Prompts means cause or bring about an action or feeling. It causes, you know, or brings about an action or feeling. So all of you write these words meanings in your notebook. Have you written them? Good. If so, now we have some task, and the first task is match the words in column A with their meanings in column B. Dear students, you have written down the words meanings in your notebook and you have got the meanings from the paragraphs. So we are going to do the first task, that is match the words in column A with their meanings in column B. So you have to tell me the correct meanings, okay? So the first word we have is prolong. So can you tell me the correct meaning for this word prolong? What is it? Is it being less bright, or to produce, or any sticky or dirty substance, or to cause something to be in a particular condition, or to make something last longer, or notices, or extremely important? Which one? Now, I want to give you time to do this task, and then I'll ask you, please, all of you, match it. Are you doing? Good. I hope you might have already finished. Now, it's your time to tell me the correct meanings, okay? So the first word, prolong, which is the correct meaning here? Wow, good. The correct meaning is that, see, to make something last longer. You are right. Good job. Now, another word we have again is essential. So what is the correct meaning for the word essential? So what is it, all of you, tell me loudly? Oh, yes. Essential means again extremely important. Okay? Extremely important. Now, another word we have is fading. What is the correct meaning here? Wow, you are again correct. That is being less bright. Okay? Being less bright. And another word again we have is generate. So what is the correct meaning for this word generate? Can you tell me? Oh, yes. See? To produce. You are right. Next word we have gunk. If you use your mobile, you know, you can find your mobile gunk. Okay? So what does it mean? Gunk. Yes, you are right again. That is any sticky or dirty substance. Now, another word we have is render. So what does it mean? Render means, you are again correct, my students. Render means to cause something to be in a particular condition. Now, the last word we have is notification. And what does it mean? Okay, we have only one option. That means notices, information, okay? These are the correct meanings of the given words. So, are you all right? Good. Now, after this, we have again another task, and that is true or false. So, all of you be ready to tell me either true or false. And in your free time, you can write them down in your notebook, okay? So, now you have to tell me orally, okay? Now, the first one, it's a good idea to keep our phones full charged, 100% charged. Is it true or false? See, it is false because that can damage our battery, okay? 100% every time. So next, B, we should keep our phones together with other gadgets. We have to keep our mobile phone with laptop, desktop, and some other gadgets. Is it true or false? Is it? Yes, you are right, false. Why? Because other gadgets generate heat, and that may damage our mobile battery, okay? C, a phone is likely to hold more bacteria than a toilet seat. Which one is dirtier? Which has more, let's say, bacteria? Mobile phone or toilet seat? Oh, yes, we have discussed, you know, and that is true. A phone is likely to hold more bacteria, okay, than a toilet seat. It is true. So, we have to wash our hands, you know, we have to regularly clean our smartphone. Number D, setting a screen lock on the phone helps us keep the information safe. Is it true or false? So, if you don't keep any lock system, then I may take your information very easily. So, what does it mean? Is it true or false? Yes, you know, you are right. It is true. Now, the last one is E. Smartphones are very useful even without apps. So, what do you think? So, without apps, can you use your smartphone? No. So, we need applications, you know. Then only smartphones become more useful. That's why it is false. false, you are right. Okay, I want to clap for your right answers. Now the next task we have is answer the following questions, and I want to give you some model questions, and rest of the questions answer you have to do at your home. Okay, so answer the following questions. Now you can tell me orally, write any three uses of smartphones in everyday life. So you can find this question's answer in the first paragraph. For example, I want to show you. So these lines are from the first paragraph. Okay, you can find this answer there. And again, from here also, you can get your answer from these lines, like staying connected with family and friends, but also in getting work done, you know, staying up to date with important schedules, and even buying groceries or clothes online. So how do you write your answer? Dear students, in comprehension question answer, you don't need to write down complete sentence. You can write down only the main ideas that is sought by the question. Okay, so your answer can be like this: staying connected, getting work done, and buying things online. See, what are the three uses? See, staying connected, one use; getting work done, another use; buying things online, another use. So three uses of smartphones, for example. This is how you can write down. Again, I want to show you another example for question number B. Why should we give care for our phones? And again, you can find this answer in the first paragraph from these lines, okay? And the main ideas are given here: to prolong its lifespan, and also to safeguard important information that's stored there. And your answer can be also the same: to prolong its lifespan, and also to safeguard important information that's stored there. So have you got my point? Good job. If so, now question number C, D, E. Why should we not use cheap chargers to charge our phones? You can find its answer clearly there. You have to write it down in your notebook, in your free time, at your home. D, how can we prevent our phones from getting overheated? Okay. E, how can the phone be cleaned? So can you do these? Good. After this, I have a task for you as your home assignment. And your home assignment is, what gadgets do you have at your home? How do you take care of them? So you can write down more gadgets, okay? I have given you an example here about mobile. So I can write down, I have a mobile phone at my home. I do not keep it with other gadgets. See, this is how I take care of my mobile phone, okay? And you can write down here, I have a mobile, a laptop. This is how you can add more gadgets. And at the same time, you have to write down, how do you take care of those gadgets? Is it clear to you? Good. So don't forget to do this task and to show your English teacher. Dear students, we have come to the end of our today's class. I hope you might have enjoyed and learned a lot to do comprehension exercises. Please read this text once again at your home. It's all for today. Have a wonderful time. Goodbye.